In 1989, the Indigo Girls' first album went gold, and they won a Grammy for Best Folk Recording. Not bad for a debut album, I'd say. Hi there, I'm Denise Donlan, and today in the spotlight, the Indigo Girls. Now, these two girls, Emily and Amy, met while they were in the sixth grade. It wasn't until they reached university that they actually called themselves the Indigo Girls, but their first record right off the bat was one that obviously a lot of people liked. When they recorded it, such luminaries as R.E.M. and the Hot House Flowers and Luca Bloom all came down to give them a hand. Over the years, they've recorded a couple records. The second one was called Nomads, Indians, and Saints. And in 1992, they released Rites of Passage, and they continued with the theme of the musical guests and included people like Mary Chapin Carpenter and David Crosby and the Roaches. Now, Amy Ray explained that we've just gone with the flow. We don't like to be pigeonholed by whatever type of music is, and it seems that the flow is serving them very well. Today in the spotlight, we've got the Indigo Girls coming up right after this.
It was like the ultimate goal and success and fame and fortune and all that. And those were never really where our interests were, but we did shop our independent album around, just kind of like to throw it out and see what the record companies thought, and of course they all rejected it promptly, and we were like, well, oh well.
Good.
We were going to get an independent label, but then Epic showed a keen interest as soon as the guy from Epic heard us. He was like all over it, you know, all over the music, and it was just a matter of weeks after that, but they were really the only ones. I mean, our album is just filled with soul-searching, bleeding heart stuff, you know, but I mean, everybody's looking. As long as you're alive and you're a human being, you don't stop looking for one thing or another. You know, we're really looking for kind of like a sense of balance or harmony, however you want to call it. I mean, we really believe that people can come together, you know. As much as that sounds like a hippie, passe thing to say, Amy and I both really believe that. But you got to get through all the
best way to present your ideas.
It keeps the focus a little more direct. I don't know. I mean, some of the songs could work with a band, a full band, electric. I don't know. Maybe it keeps the vocals out front more.
You wrote this record separately, both on your own. Is there any chance that maybe in the future you'll actually get together and co-write material?
Like, she likes to write in total silence. I like to have a lot of stuff going on, like be in the middle of a bar. It would be hard. It would be a very weird song.
Well, we write so differently. We have different influences and different styles, and we express things differently lyrically. So the collaboration comes in during the arrangement process, where we work out the harmonies and guitar parts and dynamics and all that stuff.
So how different are you? I mean, what's your basic, where do you sort of meet and where do you go apart when it comes to songwriting?
It's yin and yang,
is it?
Totally.
Is it? Really?
Yeah, for the most part.
Eagle and I saw you bleed through the thunder. I could hear you scream. Solitude, the air I breathe. Open night, fast asleep. Falling softly as you play. No footsteps ringing in your ears. Ragged down, worn to the skin. Pour your rage, you have no fear. Secure yourself to heaven. Hold on tight, the night has come. Fasten up your earthly burdens. You have just begun. Secure yourself, I saw you bleed. Hold on tight, the night has come. Fasten up your earthly burdens. You have just begun. Fast asleep.
Love is but a song we sing, is the way we die. You can make the mountains ring, or make the angels cry. Oh, the bird is somewhere.
how to love one another right now. Some may come and some may go, we will surely pass. When the one that left us here returns for us at last, we are but a moment's sunlight fading in the grass. Yeah, come on people now, smile on your brother, everybody get together, how to love one another right now. Just one key unlocks them both, it's there at your command. Come on people now, smile on your brother, everybody get together, how to love one another right now. Yeah, come on people now, smile on your brother, everybody get together,
had a teacher in common in high school, Ellis Lloyd, this man who really pushed the literature thing on us in a big way. And so we both found that to be, I think that's one of the reasons I did, found that to be like a major influence over everything that we did.
Yep, me too.
In our life.
Definitely. We were both English majors in college too. Yeah. Amy was religion too.
Like I think since I got out of college and I was a religion major and I've moved away from reading so much, I mean I read more Native American studies, for instance, rather than Anglo-Saxon type things, Western things.